Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how we can create Arduino project with MIT App Inventor. And in this project, we are going to create one fire alarm app. Okay, so we are going to use your Arduino Uno and MIT App Inventor. Okay, so in this video, we will learn how we can create app, Android app for this project. Okay, so first of all, we need to log in to ai2.appinventor.mit.edu. Then click on start new project, and my project name is, it means this is your app name. Okay, so fire warning app, and okay, so that's the first screen. Okay, so we need to use here only two components in the screen, and first one is the list picker. Left side you'll find list picker, and we're going to use your one label. That's it. Now let's click on the screen, and you can make this one vertical align should be in a center, okay, like this, and horizontal this is also in a center like this. Click on list picker, okay, and you can change the property of this. Okay, so how we can do this? So in the left side you find the background. So what you can do, let's click on background, change this something orange, or just select and change the text of this, and this is the text is something. Okay, this is the connection. So once we click on this, click on connection list picker, so we will redirect to the Bluetooth device. Okay, and we need to select, or we need to connect our Bluetooth. In the value, we have to receive value, right, from the Arduino. Okay, so this will, I'll just set as a default value like this. Good, that's it, that's the design. Now in the left side you will find the media option. And as you can see here, there's sound. Just drag and drop this. Okay, now we need, whenever we receive the value zero, so we have to we have to play the warning sound. Okay, so how we can do this, I'll explain you what is zero and one. Okay, so zero is simple. So whenever we use the fire alarm sensor, okay, so that will give us two values, zero and one. One, it means everything is fine, there is no flame, there is no fire. And if we're receiving the zero value from that sensor, it means there is something fire in around that sensor. So whenever we receive the zero value, so we have to play that sound. Okay, so with sound, so you can download any song. So I already have that one song, this one. Okay, this alarm sound. So I'll just drag and drop this, or just click on the source file, click on upload file, click on choose file, and select this file, and okay. Let's wait some second to upload it. Now in the left side you will find this uploaded. Now in the left side you will find the Bluetooth connectivity, because we have to connect our app with Bluetooth. So Bluetooth client, we have to just drag and drop it. That's it. So that's our overall app. Now let's go to the block. Okay, so here what we need to do here, so click on list picker, and as you can see here, when list picker before picking, so before picking, click on the list view, and as you can see here, list the elements. So this is the element. So what's the element? Element means the Bluetooth addresses. Okay, so we need to just go to the Bluetooth client, and as you can see here, address and name. So just see address and name, just drag and drop this here. So we will receive the all Bluetooth address in this list. Okay, so after picking, okay, so click on list view. As you can see, we have received the all value after picking. So this is after picking. So we have to connect our Bluetooth with Arduino, right? So for that, what we need to do here, for that we need to just click on the list picker, okay, or just list picker dot selection, this one, set list picker dot selection, this one, two, okay, to the, click on Bluetooth client, and you will find here the Bluetooth connect option. This one is here, this one, okay, and which address we have to connect? We have to connect list picker dot selection. Okay, so list picker, because we have selected that Bluetooth, so list picker dot selection, it means our Bluetooth connected to the Arduino. Okay, now what we need to do, we need to receive the value, okay, from that particular sensor, okay, flame sensor. So how we can get that? So we are going to use here one clock. Okay, so why we are using clock? The go to the sensor. The clock is something because we have to fire that time after every second, because otherwise we will use the button, then we have to check on when we click on the button, then we will receive the value. But because we want that value very oftenly, like in every few seconds or every 10 seconds or every 5 seconds. Okay, so for that we are using here clock. Okay, so clock, just click on clock, and I see the timer. Okay, so every second what will happen, we'll use control if, and you can use the maths logic here and this one, if the Bluetooth client receiving value. Okay, so as you can see here, Bluetooth bytes app level to receive. If there is any byte or any data to receive, okay, from the Bluetooth, so we have to check this is the greater than zero or not. Okay, so first, if it's greater than zero, okay, if it's greater than zero, then we have to get that value. So we will set that value in some label. So as you can see here, that the label is label one. So we will set that value in label. So label one, set label dot text, this one. And here we will use your one text, and we are going to use your one segment. Okay, so why we are using segment? So let me just explain you why we need it, because whenever we get the value, we will receive the multiple one, multiple zero, right? So we need only one or zero, only one time. Okay, so how we can get that? So it's really simple. Whatever the value we are receiving, okay, using text, okay, so we are going to segment that value, or we will just cut the whole value and just get the only first value. So how we can do this? So let's just segment this. And what's the text? Your text is something, click on Bluetooth, and you will find your. So click on that. As you can see, the receive text. So just drag and drop it. You will find the receive text. Number, byte. See, receive text, this one. So this is our value. Number of bytes. So as you can see, the number of bytes. So we will say whatever the byte is available. Okay. So suppose if bytes available, so we will receive everything here. Right? And we'll start this. Okay, what we need to do here, we need to start this from one and we'll end it on one, because we just need a one byte only, right? One and one, done. Now what we need to do here, we need to use your if else condition again. Under that, if the value whatever we receive, okay, from the Bluetooth, if the value is equal to zero, okay, so let's go to the maths, or you can use the logic also. Let's maths. If the value, it means label one dot text, if the value label one dot text is equal, if the value is equal, then we will raise the alarm. It means we will play that sound. That's it. If value is one, it means everything is safe, right? So that's the overall code to raise the alarm or to play that warning sound, okay, whenever we receive the value zero from our sensor to our mobile app. Okay, so this is the app. Just now in the next video, we will learn how we can connect the Arduino and how we can write a very basic code of Arduino, and then how we can connect Bluetooth module with our phone, and then we will just check this, how this will work. Okay, so thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel, like this video, and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.